Hi, my friends, CA here, and this week's book pick is the picture book, Who Says Women Can't Be Computer Programmers? The Story of Ada Lovelace. The reason I chose this book is because it's all about a field of work, computer programming, that has a bias, that it's something that men and boys are interested in. And as somebody who works in digital and computers, I thought this was a great fit as a story to encourage young girls that computers are an area that women can play, not only play a part in now, but played a part in historically. Her mother, Ava's mother, she didn't want her daughter to grow up with a wild imagination like her father, the poet Lord Byron. So she raised Ava with the mind of a mathematician with all of her studies. There was a chance meeting with the scientist Charles Babbage that sparked Ava's interest. So she was intrigued by the inventions that Charles had come up with, the machine that he created, and it was seeing this machine where she realized that her interest in sort of math and imagination can work hand in hand. So all that stuff that her mother was trying to get her away from actually played a big part in taking somebody else's idea and thinking bigger. While Charles had the original idea of the analytical engine to weave and calculate numbers to do whatever you coded them to do, Ava's imagination took her into seeing how this machine could do more than just numbers, but also be used to display pictures very similar to what computers do today. There's a few things I liked about the book. Is one, just this idea that imagination and sort of science, maths can work together. They don't have to be a distinct difference between them. That actually imagination can fuel a lot of great ideas based on math and science and what Ava's done, and can see the possibility of a machine or a calculation or a thought into a bigger future picture. And imagination is one of those things that I think more for our kids that we need to encourage, and this is a great story to talk to that point. She had enough courage in herself or comfort in herself to ask those questions about how sort of things work and have you thought of, and so she, even as a girl, didn't let the whole mindset that girls shouldn't necessarily be educated, the purpose of girls is to be married and raise a happy family. She thought of herself beyond that and fed her interest and desire in understanding and seeing how something could be taken to the next level, which I think is a great example for our girls, for our daughters now. Who says women can't be computer programmers? A good addition to your home library to expose girls to a variety of other career choices or paths that, and a lot of times, have been viewed as purely something dominated by men. Not even just now, we're hearing about more women entering these fields, but just historically, we're seeing that there were some pretty single-minded, strong, ambitious women who did kind of start to pave the way for more women to enter those areas. You can find me here on Wednesdays talking about books for kids, a little bit of geek twist, maybe books that you haven't thought of adding to your child's home library. If you like this content, like to see more content like it, be sure to give it a little thumbs up, but don't forget to subscribe so you know when the next video is published. And until next time, one to beam out.